This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. As we continue to listen, learn, and grow, we are amplifying Black voices and perspectives in an effort to start a new COVID-19 vaccine conversation. We're sharing stories intended to help us navigate this unprecedented time together and to co-create solutions in support of the Black community. Hear these stories at WeConsiderWA.org.
Wenatchee is gorgeous in the spring with its lush green rolling hills, abundant wildflowers everywhere, and the views of the Columbia River. The local food scene offers an abundant selection of authentic international cuisines featuring the unique farm-fresh ingredients of the region. Wenatchee is also home to award-winning wines, handcrafted hard ciders, and a talented handful of local brewers producing fine craft beers. Visit Wenatchee, the heart of Washington State.
Hey, this is BJ. Thanks for listening to our show's podcast. If you're a fan of all things geeky, you should check out my other podcast, BJ Shea's Geek Nation. We have new episodes every day, and you can check it out at bjgeeknation.com.
Your home is going into foreclosure, and you feel like a financial wreck. You don't know where to turn for accurate information. I'm bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne. Let's talk about some legal options. If we work quickly, we can propose a plan to save your home, modify the loan, or in many cases, even eliminate your second mortgage. The consultation is free. I've helped hundreds of people just like you make informed decisions about whether to save their home or exit it on a reasonable, organized timeline. The chapter you choose sets the tone for the next chapter of your life. Please contact me today at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com.
99.9 KISW, the Rock of Seattle. This is a very strange video that you can check out on the BJ and Migs page of KISW.com. It's a woman in Columbus, Ohio, who trained her two pet rats. Yeah, she's got two pet rats. She trained them to return to their cage every time she sings their special song. Wow, this is a movie. I think I've seen this movie. Here she is making this happen.
Here we go. All rats to the cage. All rats to the cage. Come on. All rats to the cage. All rats to the cage. Come on. All rats to the cage. All rats to the cage. Good job. Good job. Good job. Good job. Good job. And a very good job. And a very good job. Woo!
But she's got to get them to go into a slipper first. Is that the idea?
Makes it easier.
Yeah, it's like a little elevator for them.
Yeah.
It's like a carrying cage.
You don't want to leave your rat's cage on the ground.
No, that's Billy Corgan.
Yeah.
That was horrible.
Wow.
Hey.
Wow. So,
the joke
they
or
know,
the song?
Yes.
Both.
They know to go to the slipper. And then does she put the slipper on after the rats have been in the slipper?
I don't know. It's not a slipper. It's like a carrying case.
Oh,
like
it's a carrying case. Yeah, it's not a slipper.
Oh, I think from what I saw in the video, it looked like it was like a little okay, I get it.
Yeah.
Oh, and then she transfers them to
the cage.
Oh.
Yeah, so it goes from like the portable cage to the permanent cage.
Yes, now I see. Okay, well.
Do you include this in your bio on your Tinder page, or do you leave this out because you're afraid that this might scare a few people off?
Yeah. Wow.
Well, yeah, I think you need to let someone know before you end up at their house.
That you have lots of rats.
That you'd be like, hey, just to let you know, I've got a couple rats.
I don't know. I wouldn't be too pets. Like, I wouldn't be weirded out by someone having pet rats.
I would.
You would?
I am.
Like, I mean, like a handful of them maybe, but two of them? Like, would you be weirded out if they had a hamster?
Hamsters are not rats.
I know they're not rats, but I mean,
rats are rats. I mean, hamsters have always been pets.
What if she said she had two mice?
Even mice are not rats.
Yeah,
I mean,
but
rats are rats.
I'm dumb enough to not even know the difference. So if I went in there, I'd be like, oh, they look like mice. Okay, cool.
Look, mice go and they run around. They're sometimes blind. They sometimes do experiments for us. You know, that's why they never get in groups of three, because apparently they lose their eyesight when they're in groups of three.
Yeah,
so you don't want that to happen.
That was horrible.
And, you know, but rats. I mean, you're from New York, Steve. Rats.
Yes, I know.
You're from New York.
No, there are some. I know what BJ means. There are some scary looking rats. But those are rats like hanging out in the sewers, and they're all like, they look like someone just dumped like some like grease on them, and some of them are almost human sized.
Some of them mentor Ninja Turtles, you know.
Yeah,
so.
Those are the scariest ones.
Yeah,
because they'll eat your pizza.
There are.
You don't think? Yeah, you don't think they communicate? You don't think they talk to each other and send like, you know, little ratograms and stuff like that?
Those ratograms.
Yeah. Follow me on Ratagram at Steve the Rat Lover 69.
Yeah. See, so you know you're on Ratagram. You know they talk, and I think those two rats are just, you know, waiting to build her trust up. Hey, listen, we know this stupid song we listen to. She thinks we're her buddy, and then one day when she's singing that song,
We shall have our vengeance.
All I did was Googled pet rats, and now I have found out that the pet rats are called fancy rats.
Oh.
So there's at least two different types. There's the fancy rats, okay. And there's like the sewer rats.
So she said, hey, come over back to my place just to let you know I have a couple of fancy rats.
So what is it? Is it environment or is it heredity? I mean, how do you become a fancy rat?
I feel like environment. I feel like, you know, it's kind of like, you know,
yeah.
Maybe your parents send you to Bel Air because times are tough in Philadelphia.
Oh, I see what you mean. So it's the fresh rats of Bel Air is what you're talking about. Okay. All right. So we're talking about this is nurture as opposed to nature. All right.
Got a little trouble in the sewers, you know?
I see. Hey, you know what? We got to get him out of here. Really? Yeah. Let's send him over to Uncle Reddy.
Poor rat got one little fight and mom got scared.
Yeah, but you know what? Have you seen the Sirius show? I hear the Sirius show is a little bit more serious and not, you know, maybe it's,
I'm not weirded out by someone having rats as a pet.
Yeah, no, my girlfriend really wanted a rat for a while after seeing Ratatouille. She was like,
of course.
Because rats are highly trainable, apparently.
And when they talk, they sound like Patton Oswalt.
It's true. Yeah, and they would make us dinner every night.
Ah, well, I mean, look, if you got a highly trained rat that'll make you dinner and talk like Patton Oswalt, I mean, sure. I think at that point, I'll be open to the idea. But if he talks like Gilbert Godfrey, I want nothing to do with him.
The texter says rats are really smart, fiercely loyal to their owner, and really loving. Rats are awesome. I think it's just the name, rats.
Yeah.
But see, I'm a Pearl Jam fan, so I like that song, Rats.
Oh, see, I'm a Ghost fan, so I like rats as well.
Yeah.
All right, well, I don't like my stuff chewed up fan and don't take my cheese fan. That's what I am.
My child does that, though. I mean, like, you know.
Allison, why do you think I have child traps around my house? I just, in case your child decides to wander up to Mercer Island, we got a child and a rat problem. We can take care of both right there.
See, I'd just be more scared that she has the power to be able to convince rats to do these things. Like, what kind of, like, weird powers would she be able to pull on you? With your song.
Oh, you mean if she started singing and all of a sudden I go into a trance?
Yeah. I don't know. Trash goes outside. Take the trash outside.
I think we'll take the trash outside. Yeah. All right, all Steves, take the trash outside. All the Steves, take the trash out.
Or all of a sudden you're in a cage.
Yeah.
You just start running in. I'm in the cage.
Looking at the rats, be like, the hell's going on? Like, we don't know either, man.
I had everything blacked out, and all of a sudden I was here.
One day we were living in a sewer, next day we're hanging out with this singing lady.
Wow.
And nobody wants to date her.
Well, Well, you know, congratulations to everybody involved.
Now we know what to get BJ for Christmas.
Yeah,
I bet you like Peppino the Christmas mouse.
Yeah. Peppino's an Italian mouse, by the way. You know, he has nothing to do with Christmas. They gave that to the donkey.
Oh.
I did like the song. I think that they tried to make mice and rats look good. I mean, Mickey and Peppino and, I don't know, Speedy. Was Speedy Gonzalez? Was he a rat or a mouse? I forget.
Arriba.
He was the fastest mouse in all of Mexico.
Yeah. See, so they're trying to make you feel like that rodents aren't bad as far as like the mouse kind, but. You know
what? What about the song by Michael Jackson?
The Ben song?
Yeah.
Well, that was about Willard. I mean, that was like Ben was like Willard's like head mouse in charge or whatever.
Yeah, I know. You guys blew my mind with that. I truly thought that Michael Jackson had a friend named Ben. That was a rat. And I was like, yeah, he lived a tough life. Yeah. Poor guy.
Yeah, he sure did.
He wrote a song about his pet mouse.
Yeah.
Or rat.
Yeah. See, that's the problem. I saw too much Willard. That was my thing. We got this guy that shared a crazy story, even crazier than the mouse lady, about how his life was saved by a seal. All right, not a rat. It was saved by a seal. Steve will tell you all about it. He's got the mix report for you at 6:25. 3 on The Rock.
BJ and Migs, mornings on The Rock, 99.9 KISW.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. When we think about the COVID-19 vaccine hesitancy in the Black community, let's remember, it didn't happen by chance. It's justified in history. But the will to change the narrative is strong today, and our people are lending their voices to the conversation. We're sharing our stories and the reasons that made us choose the vaccine so we can lead the way for others to make a well-informed choice, too. To hear our stories, visit hearforuswa.org.
99.9 KISW, The Rock of Seattle.
If you're hearing an informative newscast right now, well, then you must not be listening to BJ and Migs. Live from the KISW News Center in downtown Seattle, this is the Migs Report.
Well, thanks, guys, and today is a very special. It's Fat Tuesday, you guys.
Oh, that's right.
Get those beads out. Throw them.
Yeah.
Right. Sweet. Does it start today, the bead part, or do we wait till tomorrow?
No, today.
Okay.
Yeah, today's the day that you go all out.
I don't know all the rules. Can I eat crawfish today?
Yes, you can.
All right, Rev, you want to go eat some crawfish with me?
I'll pass.
I knew it.
In. Get a Louisiana roll.
Oh, it's nice. Time to go to QFC.
See?
And get the greatest sushi roll of all time, the Louisiana roll. Let's go.
Let's go.
Look at this. Look at this excitement.
It's also National Pig Day. You saw Peppa.
Hey, Peppa.
That's right. George and Mommy Pig and Daddy Pig.
Wow, I'm so impressed and also depressed for you at the same time.
Dude, I read 7 Peppa Pig books yesterday to my daughter.
Seven?
Wow.
Daddy Pig. I don't know. I didn't realize that you were such a voracious reader.
That's the most I've read in 7 years.
Yeah, I'm very shocked. Like, you're like, you know what? I think I can call myself a reader.
She's
now
on this new kick of, like, liking her father. So, you know, she's asking me as opposed to mom to read books to her.
Oh, snap.
I mean, she still asked mom to read stuff. But, man, she knew she had the advantage on me. Because, like, mom will shut it down after a couple. She's like, I'm done. Yeah. And then, like, you know, we move on. Where dad's like, you're giving me attention? What do you want me to do for you? I got you.
I'm glad you brought that up because I saw some pictures and I'm like, wow, it seems like she's enjoying your company again.
Yes, again. This is the first, BJ.
Oh, I thought there was at least one day, one time where she liked you.
Yeah, she's tolerated me for the last 2 years. Now she seems like she legit hugged me yesterday.
Oh! What's going on?
I think I'm turning. I think I'm finally getting on. I think she's starting to. I'm growing on her like a wart. Like eventually, you just get used to them.
Yeah, I think it was the Kraken. I think you had her watching one Kraken game, and she's like, "All right, I think this guy's okay."
Yeah,
I
turned a corner, man. It's a good time right now in my household. I tell you.
All right.
I'm asked to play with her as opposed to being told no, don't play with us.
I know, really, man.
You're like 2 years.
You're like, kid, it's a good thing you turned the corner because you were, you know, you and I were about to have, like, that's it.
I was like, we were at the fire wrestling over the weekend. One of the guys that flew in is a guy by the name of Rocky Romero. He wrestles over at New Japan Pro Wrestling. He's a super nice guy. And he's like, how are things going? How are things with the kid? And I'm like, she likes me now. It's taken 2 years. And somebody overheard us. I was just like, what? Like, well, it's a dad thing.
It is. It really is. But I know what you're talking about. Sometimes it takes a while for the kid to actually give you the same kind of, like, you know, respect you deserve.
I think it's whichever person in the family is not around the most thing. Not really. Just, you know, if the dad's home all the time, then I would imagine mom doesn't get the love that she would want. But in my situation, it finally happened, BJ.
Look at you, man. Congratulations.
All right, let's head to California where this story is just like, if it was a dolphin, I'd say it's a really bad premise to a movie for a movie about Flipper. Because apparently this guy fell into the ocean. He was a boater in California, and his life was saved all because of a seal. Wow. Apparently the seal just nudged him along, like would dip under the water and nudge him and help him keep afloat until he was able to reach an oil rig. The guy's name is Scott Thompson, and here he is explaining what happened with him and this hero seal.
I just started swimming as hard as I could towards the boat. And it really didn't take too long to realize, like, it's getting farther. I'm not getting closer. I hear this splash. It's just this little harbor seal. The seal would go underwater, and he came up and nudged me. Like a dog would comes up and nudges your leg. Did it know, like, hey, this human's in trouble. Come on, keep going, dude.
How about that?
Wow. All right. I don't know was it bothersome or did it actually push him? I don't know.
Was it trying to eat him and just not very good at it?
Yeah. Or was he testing to see, oh, he's still moving. All right, I'll wait a little longer. He's still moving. Yeah. I don't know if the seal's intentions were good there. I can't tell.
It'd be great. We interviewed the seal. So he's like, I was just trying to eat him. I just don't know how to break the skin.
This guy pissed me off. I thought he was really done for. Next thing you know, he makes it to the rig thing. All right. Well, now I got to go find food elsewhere.
All right, here's a story that, of course, happened in Florida, and it involved a 27-year-old man by the name of Matthew. It happened over the weekend where I guess he stole a pickup truck. He had a girl with him in the car. They also tried to rob a tire store at gunpoint, but fortunately for the tire store, they had no cash in the cash register. They weren't able to leave with anything. Well, then the cops start chasing the truck because the truck, they realized, was stolen, and then the truck broke down, and then I guess he apparently got into an SUV and tried to hit a cop with it, and that's not where... That's now I'm about to tell you, is where the story gets crazy, like as if that wasn't crazy enough.
All right.
So they get the SUV surrounded. This Matthew guy, he goes up through the sunroof, and he's got a rifle in one hand and a bush light in the other. a bottle of Busch Light, too.
Okay.
So he's fancy.
Oh, all right.
And then he takes the beer bottle and just smashes it over his head.
Oh, he's serious.
He's like, you do not want to mess with me. Well, because of all the lights that were on the car, one of the cops thought that when he smashed that beer bottle that he shot off the rifle. Because of the sound of the... So they shot at him, and they hit him in the neck.
Oh, damn.
And he's going to be okay.
Wow.
Of course, he's going to be arrested, I mean, but he's going to be okay.
Whoa, dude, you can get shot in the neck and be okay.
Must have just kind of grazed. I don't think it went through the neck. I'd imagine it just kind of clipped the neck.
Damn, dude, this is your life. You know, you go, okay, breaking bottles on my head and getting shot in the neck. This is the high point.
I don't know if that was a date, but that had to be a pretty crazy experience for the woman in the car as well.
Yeah, you got to wonder about that, too. It's like, oh, this is my boyfriend right here.
Hey, the Seahawks now, there's not much going on in the Seahawks world right now, but there's some talks about possibly some international play happening this season, BJ.
Really? Boy, I better, you know what? I took them off my Twitter page, but I better put them back on.
In all fairness, he still follows them, Russell, I think.
Last I checked, he's not getting traded. I want to stay here, Steve. I really, really do. I want to stay here as a Seahawks fan, but if somebody else wants me as a fan... I'm not ruling it out.
Yeah, I want to stay a Seahawks fan, but there's four teams that I would be a fan of if the Seahawks don't want me to be their fan.
I mean, look, I want to be, but you know, if they don't get a better, you know, offensive fan line to protect me, I mean, what am I going to do?
Go Hawks.
There's nothing to do with Russell Wilson. Oh, I mean, obviously he plays with the Seahawks, but there's a chance we'll be playing internationally, so maybe you should start planning your vacation. Now, they're not one of the five teams set to host an international game, but they're playing three of those five teams, so some people are like, there's a chance that one of those games could be happening maybe in England because they're playing the Saints. Could happen in Germany because the Bucks are going to be playing in Germany.
Oh, okay.
Or it could happen in Mexico City because the Arizona Cardinals are playing in Mexico City. They haven't announced exactly the schedule and all that stuff just yet, but that would be kind of cool.
Yeah, man.
Last time we went to England to play the Raiders and we beat them, so we're really good outside of America.
Oh, that's a good point. You know, let's go do it.
For a game, yeah.
And let's add to the rumor mill. There's talks, BJ.
Yes?
Of the NBA expanding.
Oh!
According to Bill Simmons, who's the founder of Ringer, and he's close with people in the NBA, and he says he has some intel about the NBA expansion, and it could be happening soon, and there's two cities that they want to bring franchises to.
Oh, really?
One of them being Las Vegas.
Oh, okay.
And the other one being Seattle.
Oh, hey, wait, aren't those the two latest expansion franchises in the NHL?
How about that?
Wait a minute, this seems okay.
Both have nice new arenas?
I hadn't thought about that, did I? Okay, maybe I did.
Oh, dude, how great would that be? That's why when all the basketball fans were bitching, I want hockey, I want basketball. I don't know why they sound like that.
That's exactly what they sounded like.
And I was just like, wow, yeah. You should be really hoping we get a hockey team because then the arena's set and ready to go.
Yeah, yeah, you know, and I mean it's great for basketball fans because we were here for the Save Our Sonics, rallies and everything.
That was fun outside the courthouse.
Yeah,
didn't work, but it was fun.
And there's a great, I mean, there really is a great history, and so yeah, that would be exciting. I hope it happens for all the Sonic fans. I really do.
Absolutely, that'd be amazing. That'd be so much fun to watch the Sonics play over at Climate Pledge Arena.
Oh, yeah. Well, you guys have talked about it. I think it would be fun to watch anything at Climate Pledge
Arena. Just another reason to go there and get Shaq's Big Chicken.
Yeah.
Oh, I hadn't even thought about that. Of course Shaq puts... I wonder if he knew, if he had an idea, like, you know what? Don't worry. I know it's all... You're like, what are you doing in a hockey arena? Believe me, there will be basketball.
Maybe.
And there will be chicken.
You get caught up in the Sonic spirit. You visit Sean Kemp's store that sells certain things before the game. And you enjoy some of those certain things, and then you get really hungry, and you enjoy some Shaq's Big Chicken.
Oh, okay.
At the game.
You know what?
Who am I to tell you what to do in your night? But that's what I'm suggesting.
Do what do what you got to do, man.
Hey, as far as weather, 55 degrees, going to rain today. That's the Migs report, and that's what's up.
Nice. Well, that's good news. That's exciting.
I thought that was kind of interesting. I mean, who knows what that means? I don't know how soon is soon, but... hey, if there's any talks about the Sonics coming back or an NBA franchise, wouldn't that be awful, though, if there was like an NBA franchise brought here and they just decided to go with a different name?
Oh, yeah, that would be horrible.
It'd be like how to instantly alienate your fan base.
There's just no way. I mean, especially since the Thunder didn't take our name. I mean, of course you got to get the Sonics back. Of course you do.
You'd be an idiot. But, you know, what if some like...
well, you know what? It wouldn't be the first time an idiot owned a franchise.
That's what I'm saying. What if there's like some like narcissistic idiot owner that has like a name that he wants? Like he wants them to be called the Beavers or something random. I don't know.
Or the Jimmies. Like, my name is Jimmy and we're going to call the team the Jimmies. Right. Yeah, you know, okay, pal. Oh, I know, Steve. I mean, you're right. We would all be very, very excited. And then Jimmy would come along and go, welcome to the Seattle Jimmies. And you'd be like, really? Oh, God, help us.
I think the city would riot.
Yeah. And also, I mean, they're very encouraged. They stayed up till 2:30 in the morning, the MLB, trying to work out the season. They're going to talk again today. And the only thing I know is they're still trying to agree on money, but they're going to expand the playoffs. And so I believe they're going to be 12 teams that make the playoffs.
And are they doing designated hitter now for both leagues?
I heard that. I haven't heard any reports of whether or not that's official, but that's what they want to do, which it's about 30, 40 years too late. They really should. It's ridiculous that the NL doesn't want to, it hasn't done it all these years. It's just dumb.
Oh, it looks like according to Rob Manfred, is that the commissioner?
That's the big guy.
He did announce that they're going to implement universal designated hitter in 2022.
Sweet. All right. There we go. That's exciting. That's
I thought I read that like a couple of weeks ago that came out.
Oh, I didn't realize that that was a done deal. So thanks for letting me know that. That's awesome. Perfect. That will help out a lot. It'll extend a lot of careers for people. It'll make the game, I think, more exciting because really, I mean, come on. And it'll be fair for American League teams. They won't have to be like, you know, at a disadvantage when they go to a National League park and play. So that's good. Love that. All right. All good news. This is all good news, Steve.
That's hope.
Oh, we're hoping. Yesterday, Steve, he did get this one right.
What kind of bear is on the California flag?
Grizzly bear.
Yes.
I wonder if Rev would have said golden bear, if that would have worked. Because it is. Isn't it a golden bear? Or maybe that's Cal's flag.
I think that's R. Kelly's favorite bear.
Whoa. Okay, then. You want a shot at beating Steve? You got it. 206-421-ROCK. We're going to play Beat Migs. We'll do that at 6:49 on The Rock.
Today's podcast is brought to you by bankruptcy attorney Travis Gagne, who's ready to answer your questions about bankruptcy. Travis, is it true that if you file for bankruptcy once, you can't file again?
Even if you filed bankruptcy before, you can almost certainly file bankruptcy again. Different types of bankruptcies have different time limits between filings. In Chapter 7, full bankruptcy, you can only file Chapter 7 once every 8 years. However, you can always, almost always file a Chapter 13 case. Chapter 13 cases can be filed immediately following a Chapter 7. They can be filed immediately following a prior Chapter 13 case. Chapter 13 is a reorganization plan, so there will be some type of monthly payment, but it's based on your budget and your ability to afford that payment. So Chapter 13 is an option in almost all cases, even with a prior bankruptcy filing.
Thanks, Travis. If you have more questions about bankruptcy, you can reach out to Travis anytime at ChooseTheRightChapter.com. That's ChooseTheRightChapter.com. Thanks for listening.
This podcast is brought to you by the Washington State Department of Health. When we think about the COVID-19 vaccine hesitancy in the Black community, let's remember, it didn't happen by chance. It's justified in history. But the will to change the narrative is strong today, and our people are lending their voices to the conversation. We're sharing our stories and the reasons that made us choose the vaccine so we can lead the way for others to make a well-informed choice, too. To hear our stories, visit hearforuswa.org.
Wenatchee is gorgeous in the spring with its lush green rolling hills, abundant wildflowers everywhere, and the views of the Columbia River. The local food scene offers an abundant selection of authentic international cuisines featuring the unique farm fresh ingredients of the region. Wenatchee is also home to award-winning wines, handcrafted hard ciders, and a talented handful of local brewers producing fine craft beers. Visit Wenatchee, the heart of Washington State.
According to the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, one in every five children killed in traffic crashes in the U.S. was a pedestrian. That's why 3M is working alongside local governments and NGOs to help improve crosswalk visibility and traffic markings in school zones, in a worldwide initiative to provide kids with a safe walk to school and access to the education they deserve. To learn more and take action, visit 3M.com/schoolzonesafety. 3M Science. Applied to life.